Hello, I'm Mr. R. Ninja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Tonight, I saw on Channel 4 a documentary by Peter Tatchell, and he is one of the protesters against the arrival of the Pope in Britain. Now, he did show the all the people were suppressed under Pope, but he could not hit the nail over the head. He could not prove that Pope is Antichrist. So this means that he was just touching the surface. From a layman's point of view, he had no theological knowledge. So that's the drawback in most of these discussions and films and all that they make, you know, protesting against Pope. But if you don't, you know, break his legs in theology, then you can't harm him. So you have to, you know, hit the nail over the head to prove that Pope is Antichrist, and then he should be condemned all over the world. But situations are propping up, as in Indonesia, you know, the people who call themselves Christians, they are in danger. And that if the riots spark up there, as this man who wanted to burn the Quran, remember that Quran is better than Bible, because this Quran is of Gentile. The moral laws of the Gentiles are written over their hearts and not in the book. So Muhammad, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he had put the moral laws from his heart and not a book, and the Christians were called the people of the book. So these Messianic Jews, when they start killing people, they created Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, and they created the bloodshed and Holocaust and everything that happened on this earth. The people get fed up with the religion, as in Russia, they locked these dog-collared priests and these frocked one hypocrites behind the bars, and they enjoyed peace. Now they have let loose those sons of Satan, putting on silken robes better than the temple rabbi used to have. And now you will see how they will create the mess in the world. If you want peace, you have to go for gospel and not for hearsay or what the people say. So gospel truth is very simple. It's not difficult. And in my so many videos, it's over 1940 now, I've explained most of the parables, basics of the gospel, everything. And I many times asked, you know, that my lectures are free. If somebody is interested in knowing gospel, then I can preach them from the very core of the heart and from the very basic. Remember that gospel, unless you receive it from our Father, and when you receive it from our Father, you receive it in full details. That is why when we preach gospel, we preach gospel with the authority of our Father, not pleasing the people. These university professors and other things, they are scratching each other's back. They are the people who are burying dead. Let the dead bury their dead. They are burying the dead letters among themselves, as they used to do in Jerusalem where the written Torah they were reading like mad people, drunk with the old wine. And when Jesus used to come and tell them something, they used to refute it. And when Jesus said, "You are mentioning about this Messiah will come, this prophet and that prophet, what about the one standing before you? Can't you recognize him?" Remember the Samaritan woman at the well, she recognized the Jew. You know what the Jews people have proclaimed or stressed? That she was a bad woman, marrying one husband after the other. So that is how these Jews, they created darkness in the world. And they suffered Holocaust. Nobody else to be blamed than they themselves. Same, you know, anything happening in this world, if people are suffering and these priests have abused them and all that, you know, it is the people's fault to go after them. Martin Luther, he protested, he opened the door a little and he led the way to protest against this Antichrist, but not many people are following his footsteps. They still are in dominant in the Catholic churches. They still follow those fathers with their dog collars or frocks as if they are men of God, and when they pray come into their hand, they abuse them. And when they are abused, then they say, "Our father has abused such and such person and this and that." Nonsense, you know. But why do you go there when Jesus has set you free? So in Pope, what we have, Matthew 12, 43 to 45, that states, you know, the added evil-spirited temple priests, when they were thrown out of the temple, Jerusalem temple in 70 AD, then they could not find green pastures. They could not find their old customers. Remember Jesus said in the last parable in the temple about the wine press? They were the husbandmen of the wine press. So when they were thrown out of the Jerusalem temple, they could not find a customer because they maltreated Christ Jesus and his laborers. James the Just and Saint Stephen, they killed him. For what wrong they have done? Nothing. So people hated them. So they cleansed the hearts of the people with the blood of Jesus and Stephen and St. James the Just. But soon after, you know, these crook temple priests in the shape of Messianic Jews or in the shape of the Messianic bishops in the churches, they lured the old customer into the churches by bringing in the bait, written Torah, rotten written Torah, old cloth full of holes, useless. Remember that when you are a royal priest, then you are greater than John the Baptist. And John the Baptist is the great, the master of this Old Testament. So why you need it when you are greater than John the Baptist? But nobody thinks like that, you know. They all are dead people in churches. 99% people are spiritually dead in churches. And so when I go there, they call me a madman, a heretic. Same when Jesus used to go into the Jerusalem temple, they called him a son of a Satan. And more than heretic, they used to call him. He was our master heretic in Jerusalem temple. So if some people call you heretic, then it is a degree, is a honor in the name of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. So when these temple priests were thrown out, the arid spirit, and they could not find a green pasture, then they entered into the church, not through the gate, by jumping over the fold. Remember, one fold, one shepherd. And then they overpowered the church. When the apostle used to come, they used to rebuke them. Do what we tell you to do, otherwise get lost. So they opened monastery. But when these temple priests turned messianic bishops, they had a strong gathering, and the Emperor Constantine came into their hands. Then they asked him, oh, these are the people are critic, heretic, kill them. So by giving them the dog a bad name, they killed them, burning them, all that. They created darkness, as I have stressed many times. So thrown out of the Jerusalem temple, took over the Church of God after the death of James the Just, and with it they brought the Jewish leaven, old cloth full of holes, the useless written Torah, and they drank with the old wine, messianic Jews. They also came with it, with the bait. Apostle rebuked them, and the messianic bishop expelled them from their churches, starting with the Judea region. Judea is the region most hated Christ Jesus. They were most spiritually sick people. His own people of Judah tribe became the staunch enemies of Christ's Christianity and its ever-living Gentile apostles. Most of the apostles were Gentile, not Jews. And they were, if there were any Jews, they were not many. Because most of the Jews, they were frightened of their own people. Popes became rulers, the cruel masters who killed apostles, subduing all freedom that Christ Jesus had assured us into the word. Remember what Jesus had brought in, they killed it. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 12, 43 to 45, the situation became worse than before. So this Pope is the Antichrist, worse than those temple priests who killed Christ Jesus. So you can well imagine what you could expect from this Pope. People sacrifice their lives in order to regain the lost freedom. Let us carry our freedom further by exposing these hypocrite popes, bishops, dog-collared hireling, etc., by promoting fellowships of royal priests that ply the double-edged sword of salvation, His word, that points to the narrow gate, far solitary to the royal kingdom of our Father God. Let us carry our own crosses to set an example to the other brethren. Remember the words of Simeon, the one when Jesus was taken to temple when he was a baby. Simeon then expressed, you know, his feeling. I have seen my salvation in Christ Jesus. Now let your servant and not the Pope Master go. So in Jesus we are servants. We are not masters, our cruel master as Pope is. So Pope is definitely a son of Satan. Thank you, Antichrist.